It's old time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordie Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky's, the loser Bobby Orr's. Hey.
Did you see that hit? And I swear to God, cross my heart, hope to die, when the score was 1-1, I went in there, Ronnie Harris, and I said, he's going to get assessed on the winner, but I never said he'd get the clincher. What a guy, the best hockey player in the world today, Dougie Gilmore, and don't you forget it, from Kingston, Ontario. Isn't he lovely? I love this guy. I love me.
All right, the stars of Kids in the Hall.
Doug Gilmore is one of the most beloved players of all time and does not get the credit that he so richly deserves. Gilmore would start his junior career playing for the Belleville Bulls in the Ontario Professional Junior Hockey League, and later the Cornwall Royals, who would start in the Q but end up in the OHL. Gilmore would have an astonishing 81-82 season, putting up 119 points in just 67 games. Good enough to catch the attention of NHL scouts, but shockingly was not drafted until the 7th round in the 82 draft, 134th overall, by the St. Louis Blues. Gilmore would remain in Cornwall for further seasoning, and in the 82-83 season would put up 177 points in just 68 games, scoring 70 goals and getting 107 assists. Why every other team would sleep on a player like this is beyond even me. Gilmore would go straight to the NHL after his run with the Royals ended and started the 83-84 season with the St. Louis Blues. And in 80 games, he would put in 53 points. Over the next two seasons, Gilmore would score no less than 50 points, and it wasn't until 86-87 when Gilmore would break out and reach 105 points in 80 games. And the following year would put up 86. It was a shock that in the following year, in 88-89, Gilmore would be traded to the Calgary Flames, where he was instrumental in helping the Flames win their only Stanley Cup, where in the regular season, Gilmore would put up 85 points in 72 games, and in 22 playoff games, score 11 goals and 11 assists for 22 points. Gilmore would spend the next 2.5 seasons with the Flames until he was traded to the Toronto Maple Leafs during the 91-92 NHL season. Doug Gilmore was definitely the spark that the Maple Leafs needed to turn their team around, and in the 92-93 season, he would put up his career best, 127 points in 83 games, 95 being assists, taking the Leafs deep into the playoffs, unfortunately not winning the cup, but securing himself a Frank J. Selke trophy as the league's top defensive forward. The following year, Gilmore would put up the same numbers, scoring 111 points in 83 games, which made it the 8th straight season that he would put up 80 points or more. It was after the 94-95 lockout year that Gilmore's point totals began to decline. Even though he was still putting up 50 points or more in every season, the Leafs would struggle to stay in or even make the playoffs. In 96-97, Gilmore was traded to the New Jersey Devils. He would finish out the 96-97 season as a Devil and only play one more full season with the team before signing with the Chicago Blackhawks for the start of the 98-99 NHL season. Gilmore was still delivering in the stats department, putting no less than 50 points up in a season, but in 99-2000 was traded at the deadline to the Buffalo Sabres. Dougie would play the 2000-2001 season with Buffalo and put up his lowest point totals to date, only scoring 38 points in 71 games. After a disappointing run with Buffalo, he would sign with the Montreal Canadiens, playing two seasons there, still putting up dismal points, and not having good playoff runs. During the 2002-2003 season, Doug Gilmore was traded once again, this time from Montreal, back to the team he is most known for, the Toronto Maple Leafs. His homecoming was bittersweet, however, as it was his first game back with the Leafs, and to his second shift, he would injure his ACL, and he would have to miss out on the rest of the 2002-2003 season. Doug Gilmore would officially retire that following September. with 1,474 NHL games played, scoring 450 goals and getting 964 assists for a total of 1,414 points, all while racking up 1,301 penalty minutes in the process. He would finish his career as a Memorial Cup champion, a Canada Cup champion, a Frank J. Selke winner, a two-time NHL All-Star, and a Stanley Cup champ in 89, and was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2011.
Box.
Boy. How'd you do it?
Kind of like animal.
Yeah, right. Hey, Dougie, what's your secret?
Hey, guys. Hard work, balanced diet, variety,
including milk.
Cold, refreshing milk.
So much shit you could keep. Bizumi and Nagi.
You could say that again.
Holy cow.
How are you going to spend your energy?
It's old-time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordy Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky's, the loser, but...